In the current climate, how are you seeing brand safety, brand suitability, those issues coming to into focus, and sort of the concerns of brands, the roles of publishers, and the
Sure.
innovation from the verification firms?
Sure. When you look at brand safety and brand suitability, there's particular attention being paid to it right now as it relates to news. News consumption has increased, but the content that people are experiencing in some ways is really challenging and concerning for some, especially when you're hearing about deaths related to COVID-19. So we know that news, premium news environments is brand safe. It's a question of what is suitable depending upon what you're trying to achieve as a marketer. So we have worked with R4A's APB, the Advertiser Protection Bureau, which reflects a collaborative group across all the major leading media agencies coming together. And we meet every week addressing what are the opportunities in the marketplace, how do we share when we see challenges going on, and then how do we really encourage support for the right news media. And so news is a great example. We published a position paper about a month ago about news and really trying to dispel some of the myths that are out there. News is brand safe. Again, back to what is suitable for you, what is appropriate. We know that premium news environments are positive places for brands to be. We know that millennials are going there in higher rates. So there's some real opportunities there. The concern is really right now on local journalism and what's happening for local news, and the monetization of that. So many of the agencies have been incredibly supportive of work that the Local Media Consortium is doing. So there's a whitelist that people can take advantage of to encourage and support news at the local level. This is something that really people have been embracing, and we've also been working with the Brand Safety Institute, part of TAG, on. So right now, the spotlight is on news. The real challenge is that media spend is down, and then you also have to pay attention to what is suitable as it relates to a brand.
So, Marla, in terms of what we're seeing now and where we're going, what are some of your thoughts about how the current situation will shape digital advertising, and particularly the role of the agency in digital advertising?
Well, I'm always going to see a role for the agency in digital advertising. And I think, especially when you're talking about brand safety and suitability, the agencies, really the people that are inside them, the brand safety officers, they are the experts, the digital experts in understanding what's out there, understanding third-party verification providers, partnering with them to ensure that brands are getting what they need to. And so as we see the evolution continuing, there's going to be more attention paid to programmatic, to increasing in terms of automation. That is not going to go away. I think there's going to be even greater desire for that moving forward. But it has to be the right channel and the right way to verify that it is appropriate content, that is not fake. The most important thing is to make sure that there is just that you are hyper-focused on ensuring that you're eliminating fraud, malware, that you're being brand safe within whatever environments that you are advertising.